Here we plug in the answer choices and see if it satisfies the inequalities. So with option A, when x is negative 2, we'll get y is less than or equal to negative 6 plus 1, which means y is less than or equal to negative 5. Now the point negative 2 and negative 1, here y is negative 1 and negative 1 is not less than or equal to negative 5. Therefore option A is wrong. Then with option B, when x is negative 1, y is 3. Substituting this in the first equation, we'll get y is less than or equal to negative 3 plus 1. Therefore, y is less than or equal to negative 2, which is not correct because 3 is not less than negative 2. Therefore, option B is wrong. Then option C, when x is 1, y is 5. Therefore, y is less than or equal to 3 plus 1. Therefore, y is less than or equal to 4. Which doesn't satisfy it again because 5 is not less than equal to 4. Therefore, option C is incorrect also. Now, option D, when x is 2, y is negative 1. Therefore, y is less than or equal to 3 times 2 plus 1. Y is less than or equal to 6. Which is correct because negative 1 is less than or equal to 6. Now, in the second inequality, 2 minus y is greater than 1 minus y is greater than minus 1. Therefore, y is less than 1 and negative 1 is less than 1. Therefore, option D satisfies both the inequalities.